Derivation of demand curve, indifference curve approach. Already we have learned how to obtain price consumption curve. I have given the link to that lesson in the description for those who didn't watch. If you are a new viewer and like my video lessons, please subscribe and not to forget to click the bell symbol to get regular updates. Now the lesson. Look at this graph, figure 1. Income of the consumer remaining constant, the price consumption curve is derived by joining the points of equilibrium at different price levels of good X. Please note, we measure income or money at the disposal of the consumer along the y-axis. To draw the demand curve, we need two information, price and quantity. To begin with, the consumer is at point E1. He buys M1 quantity of good X. What is the price? Money at his disposal is OA units. OB1 is the quantity of good the consumer can buy with entire amount. Then OA divided by OB1 gives the initial price P4. Let us use a separate graph, figure 2, to plot this point M1 P4. This graph is exactly below the first one. Price is measured along the y-axis and quantity is measured along the x-axis. C represents the point M1 P4. This is one of the points on the demand curve. When the consumer is in equilibrium at point E2, he buys M2 units of good X. The price is OA divided by OB2 P3. Plot point M2 P3 in figure 2. Point F represents this point. Similarly, at equilibrium points E3 and E4, the consumer respectively buys M3 and M4 units of good X. The corresponding prices are OA by OB3, that is P2, and OA by OB4, that is P1. Plot the points M3, P2 and M4, P1 in figure 2. Points G and H respectively represent this. Join points C, F, G and H with the help of a smooth line. What you get is the demand curve for good X. Good X is a normal good. The demand curve of a normal good always slopes downward from left to right. We shall meet in the next lesson.